What was the creepiest thing you saw while visiting someone at their house? I was at sleepover and we were watching a movie in their shed. And since we were 10 it got scary, so we went back into the house and we passed by this. What we thought was a toy snake. It was humongous. Anyway, she brushes it off saying it was probably her brother's. And we went inside. I mentioned it to her mom saying it was so cool and she was like, "What toy snake?" Turns out it was a 2-meter snake that finally was venomous. I'm Australian. Australia. Shudders. The friend's mom's boyfriend always leers at her daughter's friends, bonus if they're under 12. I had a male friend who seemed pretty normal. He was a shy nerd who had a bit of trouble making friends. We bonded over video games and anime. He left the room to greet another friend at the door. He had a notepad under his pillow and it had really detailed, beautiful drawings of me. It was flattering until I flipped further. There were pictures of me. Some were printed out screenshots of my Insta posts or friends' Snap stories. But others were just pictures of me in class or at the mall, and they weren't pictures taken to my knowledge or accidentally. He was AR, incel R, neckbeard type. We stopped hanging out after that. He started getting really creepy and pushy, and so I cut all contact with him. Monsieur Christ, that's horrible. Also having your trust broken like that by a friend. H. Monsieur, did you ever confront him? Yeah, it didn't go well. He became very nasty and offensive. He called me a nosy bitch and said some awful things to me. R. Nice guys. Carpeted bathroom. We had a carpeted bathroom and kitchen growing up. It was super short carpet. But still, that was how the builder designed it. The late 80s were really odd. One time a sack of potatoes was left forgotten in a dark corner of the pantry. On carpet. Spoiler alert. We didn't have a very clean home. We always had flies. But there were more than usual. Well, I found those potatoes had liquefied into the carpet with a manner of things and maggots growing in. And around the monsieur, I'll never forget the smell. Since I discovered it, I had to clean it. 0 tenths would not recommend. Guarantee you weren't the first to discover it. Just the first to admit it. One time I went to a friend's wedding reception, which was in a Mormon church. The reception was in the church's indoor basketball court, which was carpeted. The reasoning was that the carpet makes it quieter for people who are praying. Carpeted basketball court is something the devil would think of. His 3 dogs sitting on his mantle. They were stuffed after they died. That's rough. My husband and I were house shopping. We go with our realtor to view this one house that was super nice. Checked all of our boxes and within our price range. The first thing we noticed is there were security cameras in every single room, monsieur, even in the bedrooms, odd but whatever. We finally get to the master bedroom where there was a shrine of a maybe 5-year-old girl above the master bed. There were old bouquets of flowers and candles surrounding the shrine, which led us to believe the little girl was deceased. They even kept the girl's bedroom fully intact. We noped out so quick. They pulled the house off the market the next day. We suspect they were watching us on their surveillance. There's a hidden story there. I'd want to know. I searched the address afterward to try and find some more info. Maybe a name or something, but no luck. Something strange definitely happened there. The cameras added to the mystery. Good following of instinct, that's definitely some weird horror origin story, what in the hell? Sometimes I think video games and movies take it a bit past reality, and then I see stories like this and I remember that reality is just as fucked. It was morning and their mom put milk before cereal and she warmed up the milk. It was the summer. Horrible times. Nasty. When I was in kindergarten, my mom took us on a family vacation to visit some distant cousins in England. The first night at their house, the mom heated an entire glass bottle of milk in the oven. The entire house ended up smelling of rancid milk. I thought I was going to throw up from the stench alone. The whole family kept pressing me to have some while the children guzzled full glasses of steamy hot milk. I ended up drinking some because they told me I was being rude for refusing it. To make matters worse, it turns out I'm lactose intolerant, and their ancient toilet broke during the night. We never spoke to that branch of the family again. A wooden voodoo doll looking thing that my friend's dad bought back from his vacation to some weird third world country. It was old, so he took it to some sort of specialist who said that if it was authentic, it was definitely made with human remains. My friend told me that when I was holding the thing and as soon as he did, I noticed its teeth looked a little too real in comparison to the rest of it, so I put that shit down immediately cause, like, WTF, I'm not holding a doll made of people, that's fucked. I went with a friend to this guy's house that she was seeing. She said he had a lot of collectibles, which is fairly normal since we are both collectors ourselves. We walk into his very large house. I'm pretty sure it had 5 bedrooms. And every surface, literally every surface, was covered in figurines. I'm talking about the edges of the staircase, the banister, in between the slats on the handrail, the kitchen counters, the coffee table, the tops of the cabinets, the edge of the bathroom sink, the window sills, hanging from doorways. There were countless bookshelves and display cases overflowing with collectible items. Nothing about the collectibles were creepy. It was just your run-of-the-mill nerd stuff, but oh my god. The sheer amount. It felt like a sarcophagus. Talk about a dusting nightmare. I fix computers and go to people's houses from time to time to do so. One day, a guy who looked a vampire answered the door. He had black curtains, red walls, a literal Dhammam shrine with a pentagram, goat skull, incense and all. He was pasty white, whiter than me, and I am a ginger, wearing a black silk suit and had dark ETE circles. I walked in, looked around for about a minute as he showed me where his desk was, then pretended to get an emergency text and notepad the fuck out of there. Not about to be your next sacrifice or hex, my dude. Missed your chance to be in what we do in the shadows. Somewhere a random goth is laughing with his friends over the time his aesthetic scared a guy so much that he ran away. LMAOO, imagine literally scaring off normies. I went to visit a neighbor who had just moved into a bigger home. She had 11 children. I sat down at the kitchen counter as my neighbor was getting us tea. All of a sudden, the dishwasher slowly opens from the inside, and out crawled a kid, couldn't have been more than 18 months old. Kid looks at me, then crawls away. I thought I was on camera being punked somehow, but my friend never saw it and never skipped a beat in whatever she was talking about. It was weird, and the kid was creepy. 11 kids and only so many hours in a day. Gotta get them all clean somehow. Props for self-bathing at 18 months old. Back in high school, a longtime friend of mine used to work for a stereotypical eccentric rich guy. Mainly charity and nonprofit stuff. But he collected the rarest historical memorabilia. And my friend was giving me an unofficial tour of the room where this guy stored everything. Two that freaked me out were Haitian slave shackles from colonial times and a cracked voodoo doll that was supposedly haunted. Nope. No thank you, sir. Do you want ghosts? Because that's how you get ghosts. LANAAAA! Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. My aunt and uncle had just moved into a 3-story row home in a bad New Jersey town. I was a kid and went up to the 3rd floor where there was a lot of wood paneling on the walls. In the corner of the hallway there was a door with no handle. You just pushed in and it opened. They had just bought the house and so they hadn't really checked out this area. My cousin and I opened the door and there were no lights or windows inside. And the light from the hall was only cast about a few feet in. The remainder was pitch black. We entered the room and soon after taking a few steps I felt my foot hit some metallic objects. So I kneeled down and just at the edge of the light I see a long coiling belt of 30 caliber machine gun rounds. I remember feeling this blunt sensation of unease. My cousin and I then told our parents about it, and I remember them going in and raising their voices in disbelief and shock. I never knew what else was in that room, but it definitely creeped me out. Not necessarily visiting, but for a couple months I lived in a house with an older woman, late 80s, whom I provided care for in exchange for room and board. Rather than paying rent, her late husband had been a doll maker, and I'm not sure if he still does, but at one time he held the Guinness World Record for the smallest doll with moving parts made without a magnifying glass. The parlor was lined with glass cabinets showing some of his best and favorite dolls. Nobody really hung out in that room because it was supposed to be kept nice for visitors. I wasn't even allowed to sit on the couches. So for the whole time I was living there, that room always had a musty, impersonal feel to it, even though it was cleaned and dusted regularly. I passed through that room every once in a while to look out the front window or on my way from my bedroom to the kitchen. Every once in a while I would take a quick peek into the glass cabinet and check up on my favorite dolls. That's when I started to notice that the dolls would change directions. They'd be facing front the first time I looked at them, but later in the day they'd be facing the side or the back. I told the owner about this and she said she never noticed it, but nobody could have been moving it because the cabinets were all locked with a key she kept in a secret place in her bedroom monsieur. The only people who ever came into the house were me, her, her sister, her brother-in-law, her grandkids, and the cleaning lady once a week. The majority of the time I was just the two of us, and her family hardly went into that room anyways. I always thought it was weird, but I never really thought it was that scary. Good thing she kept them locked up, which is a totally normal human thing to do about dolls that don't move around on their own at all. I figured she kept them locked up because her husband was sort of famous, so they were probably worth a lot of money. Looking back though, I'm glad they weren't given the opportunity to randomly wander around the house. His parents doing stuff, and when I walked into his room he flashed me. Gauging your response, you almost joined the cult. Should have flashed back to assert dominance. In 2009 I went to go get my hair cut by my friend's mother when I was in my early teens. Our families were pretty close and our moms have always been friends. I should note that my friend started doing homeschool in 2007. My friend's mom came home late, so my hair appointment was pushed back until midnight at her place. I pressured my mom to get me there and to come with me to show her I wasn't lying and that I needed the haircut before my grade 8 graduation ceremony. The ride to our friend's place was roughly 5 minutes, which was faster than usual since traffic is dead during midnight hours. And we got out of the car just shy of parking in their driveway. We parked across the street to our friend's place because my mom wanted to read a garage sale sign on a pole. Just before entering our friend's house, this car pulls up in front of me and my mom and snaps a photo of us. The flash was so bright, and the only thing I saw before the flash was a silhouette of a man in short, spiky hair similar to my friend's brother. A hairstyle not too popular in my area because it was quite punkish. I couldn't recognize the car since it was dark. All I know is that it was a sedan just like my friend's brother's car. Once this person snapped the photo of us, he drove off. My mom and I were confused for a split second and we both ran inside. My mom confided in my mom's friend about what just happened, and my mom's friend was also confused. But her confusion looked contrived and didn't speak much that night. I thanked her for the haircut and wanted her to take my money that I saved up for the haircut. After that night, I didn't try to contact my friend or her mom until after graduation. I wanted to let her mom know that everyone loved my new look at graduation. I couldn't get a hold of anyone and they no longer live in that house. It was as if they were never really there. I wonder if they were in witness protection. How about your mom? Did they ever contact each other after? My mom went to the garage sale the next day. It was a few houses down from the garage sale sign we saw at midnight, but went to stop at our friend's place first. She knocked and called beforehand, but she got no answer both times. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.